Yeah, I saw the poll results. Why ice beers, though? That meme wasn't even funny.
Eugene.
Yeah, I guess they did need the support, but I don't care how much support they get. They will always get melted by my fire fist deck.
Eugene!
And, yeah, cyber dragons, too. Mr. High and Mighty's gonna like that a whole lot.
Eugene!
Speak of the devil. What?
You need to clean your room.
No, I don't.
We both know why you've been hanging out in here. You don't want to clean it. You don't want to get all the cups out of it. And you could just get over it because I'm not doing it for you.
Well, I think you're going to have to make me.
Huh? Now, clean your room.
Ew, fine.
Structure decks has ended, and we are getting an ice barrier structure deck and a cyber style structure deck. What is this? Oh yes, we're getting some kind of cyber dragon, cyber dark structure deck. At first, I didn't think that it was going to be either of those. I thought that it was just there to confuse people, and it was actually just going to be some kind of cyber deck. I don't know why I thought that. They're actually coming out with a cyber dragon structure deck. That sounds awesome. I obviously care about this a lot, and I'm just gonna spend the whole video talking about it. I'm not gonna talk about the ice barrier structure deck though, because I just don't really care as much, you know? Like, it's cool they're getting support. They definitely needed it, but like, you know, I just don't care. But I actually didn't play Cyber Dragons back in 2005 when Cybernetic Revolution came out. I actually wasn't even playing Yu-Gi-Oh! In 2005. My Yu-Gi-Oh! Story is scattered, and we could talk about it in another video, but I didn't actually start playing Cyber Dragons until the Cyber Dragon Revolution structure deck came out in 2014. And I actually used Cyber Dragons as just my budget deck at first because they were mainly an OTK deck, but they could take advantage of some rank 5 plays, but that's really all the deck did when that structure deck first came out. I played the shit out of Cyber Dragons though, and it eventually became my main deck because we had plenty of Cyber Dragon names like newly added Dry and Zvi at the time that made it way easier to get that Power Bond OTK off, because previously we didn't have very many Cyber Dragon names. We had Cyber Dragon and we had Proto Cyber Dragon and some others, but we didn't really have very many good ones. So when that structure deck came out and gave us more good Cyber Dragon names, it made the Power Bond OTK way more deadly. And I actually made some people salty, a lot of people salty at locals back in the day with it too, because like every time I saw Power Bond, I won. That's just how it was, because there were now finally plenty of Cyber Dragon names, and you were going to see them, and you actually had a search card for your Cyber Dragons. Now it's just that structure deck was great for Cyber Dragons, guys, and people were salty because going second, I would just win. And that's actually something I noticed about the deck, is that if it saw Power Bond, it won way more often. And that's why eventually I made so many videos asking for a Power Bond searcher, and then we eventually got Pharos, because I noticed that the deck was way better, obviously, if it saw Power Bond. It won way more often because you just kind of win, especially later on when we got Rampage Dragon, which popped back row and got multiple attacks. That's just nasty. But besides the Power Bond OTK and fusion plays, Cyber Dragons relied heavily on Nova back in the day. Not Nova and Infinity, because keep in mind, Infinity was not out yet. Just Nova. I mean, of course, there were other good plays. The main one, and still one that's good to this very day, is Machine Duplication on Core. That was around to be able to get more Cyber Dragon names out, but the deck wasn't exactly Tier 1, Tier 0. It was just a really fun Tier 2 competitive deck, and it won way more often going second than first because of the Power Bond OTK, and also because of Chimera Tech. If your opponent was a poor bastard playing a machine deck and you summon Cyber Dragon, I mean, you're just gonna win. You just stack their whole board. Chimera Tech Fortress Dragon is still a great card. What I'm saying here though, guys, is my love for Cyber Dragons and me learning everything that the deck can do, all the combos, all the cool techs that it can play, it all began with that Cyber Dragon Revolution structure deck. And since that was the case with me, I think it could be the case for many other players out there. Not just players that are interested in Cyber Dragons, but players that are interested in machines, and of course players that watch the anime back in the day, because everyone who watched the GX anime is going to love this structure deck, because Zane Truesdale himself played Cyber Dragons and Cyber Darks. you know, when he was going through his emo phase or whatever you want to call it from the anime. If CyberDarks can get some love in the structure deck, it would be a very good thing because they've always sucked, especially competitively speaking, so it would be really good for them. They would be, they're a cool deck. It'd be cool to actually be able to play them. Because CyberDarks at heart are an equip deck, and equip decks have a lot of inherent flaws. All of the main deck CyberDark monsters equip from the graveyard or want to be equipped from the graveyard, so you can see some of the innate problems already. Only triggering when normal summoned, equip deck, and wanting to have your graveyard loaded really fast are just all flaws. This is stacking up very quickly to be an outdated deck, which would be exactly why it needs a lot of support, and some good support at that, hopefully. Not to say that CyberDarks don't have much potential, because they do, and they even have their own fusion spell in CyberDark Impact, but they also have CyberDark Cannon, which I'm gonna pull out the laptop for, because it says, if this card is sent to the graveyard while equipped to a monster, you can draw one card. Drawing cards is always good. You can discard this card, add one machine, a CyberDark monster from your deck to your hand. During damage calculation, if a monster equipped with this card battles, you can send one monster from your deck to the graveyard. Any monster. So it has a draw effect, drawing cards is always good, a discard and add effect, good and good, and then a foolish burial effect, and you can use each of these effects once in a turn? Those are three pretty good effects, so what I'm getting at here is that there's already a lot of potential there for CyberDarks. CyberDarks are Dark Machines and Dark Dragons, so it's possible for Orcas to be integrated into the deck because they limit you to only being able to special summon Darks for the rest of the turn. CyberDark. And also, CyberDarks being Dark allows them to work with regular Cyber Dragons being Light, which opens up a lot of chaos potential. Not to mention Orcas Cyber Dragons has already been a deck, and Cyber Dragons have already gotten supports, of course, in the Cyber Dragon Revolution structure deck that I was talking about earlier, but in Cybernetic Horizon, they got support in the Legendary Dragons, and then of course they've gotten Panzer Dragon and other stuff like Rampage I was talking about earlier over the years. So with this new structure deck, guys, Cyber Dragons definitely do have a lot of potential, mad potential, to be not only another good structure deck, but another meta contender for years to come. And I'm just gonna spit some facts right now, guys. Cyber Dragons always have potential to be a meta option just because of the Chimera Tech plays. Going second, being able to break your opponent's board just with Chimera Tech gives the deck an edge. You don't need any out cards, you don't need to play any special outs. Your Cyber Dragon monsters that you're already playing enable you to out your opponent's board. It gives you an edge. Cyber Dragons are quite literally the best machine deck of all time. You could argue for Gear-Gia, Machina, Gadgets, you know, Ancient Gears, and you would be wrong. Cyber Dragon is king, and he has been king since he came out. He defined formats when it came out, and he is still defining formats right now. I might make another video on the structure deck talking about some cards that could come out of it, like maybe some sort of chaos cards, some like machine Cyber Dragon chaos cards that tie together the lights and darks, but then again, we do already have a lot of chaos cards in the game, so like, what do I know? I guess I haven't given it too much thought as to what I would want in this structure deck, but go ahead and let me know what you guys want in the structure deck, what you think is going to come out in the structure deck down in the comment section, and also let me know just how much you think Ancient Gears are better than Cyber Dragons. I know you're already typing it. I see you. I'm Yu-Gi-Oh! Jesus. I see it all. Subscribe!